Hello, cartoon fanatics, and welcome to a very late episode of Cartoon Corner on the newest Rick and Morty. Did I plan for it to come out so late? No, I did not. This is just how things turned out, so this is what's happening. Your late night dose of last late night episode of Rick and Morty. Yeah, get ready. Because, personally, this has been the one that just aired last night was my favorite episode of the season so far. So I'm really excited to talk about it. And it was buried inside me all day, like, oh, I can't wait to talk about this. So here we are. I'm just gonna let it all out. It's just gonna be word explosion, word vomit. So I'm not exactly sure where this is going to go, but here we go. Late night Rick and Morty goodness. So the episode starts where Rick and Morty are just dealing with some things in the garage, and all of a sudden they get a call from apparently this intergalactic superhero group. Morty really wants to go, Rick doesn't want to go. And Morty pulls out his coupon, which he got in the first season when he's like, I want at least one out of every 10 adventures to be a Morty adventure, or every 10 adventures is a Morty adventure. I can't remember the details on that. But we haven't seen that coupon since season one, so that was surprising to see Morty suddenly whip that out and go, I'm calling this. This is Morty adventure time. So they go and they meet up with this group called the Vindicators, which apparently they've done some superhero stuff with in the past, quote unquote. And they're kind of like this, you know, mock Avengers group where they have all these different crazy characters with all these crazy backstories, and they've all grouped together supposedly under a common good, and they've got all like these serious paths, backstories, and they're got these complicated relationships with each other, which is kind of what the Avengers has become. But to be fair, when you bring any big comic group series and just kind of smush it all together, that this is kind of what happens. It just seems to be the general arc of comic book superhero groups. So this specifically seemed like it was sort of a mock of the Avengers, but it also kind of felt like it was a mock of just the general Justice Society groups put together in comic books most of the time, which I got a kick out of. Rick is completely bored with it because he's like, I could do most of the stuff you guys do in about a tenth of the time that you do it. You're just doing it all for publicity, which is, once again, about sort of the mock thing. I'm not going to keep going back to that. We're going to move on. So Rick could care less. Morty's excited. He apparently loves these guys. He loves hanging out with them. He likes helping them out. And they are planning on taking down this guy called, I don't remember his name. He was like called Earth Destroyer or Doom Monster, something along those lines. But I remember that this is the funny part. This is kind of, I'm gonna say this now, I wouldn't say it as much in the past, but considering what just happened in this episode, watch the promos if you can. Watch the behind the scenes, sort of the little teasers that the people that make the show give you, because the promo for this one was awesome. It was just a bunch of the character design artists talking about this big baddie that the Vindicators were gonna take on, and being like, oh, he's the biggest threat yet. He's the worst thing you've ever seen. He's like a combination of Thanos and all these other bad guys, like Thanos and Doomsday, I think was what they used. And then it just pans over to Justin Roiland, and he's just sipping this water. He looks like he might be kind of hungover. And you can see the blatant sarcasm on his face. He was 120% Rick in that promo. And the minute I saw that, I'm like, This bad guy isn't going to be as bad as they're saying he is he? And not at all, because we don't even get to see him in action. He's dead the moment we see him. The guy is dead. The promos just made that so much better, because they pretended there was all this buildup and going, this guy's going to be a main villain. We got a main villain now, and nope, he's just flat out dead the minute we see him. So goodbye, big Vindicators supervillain, we hardly knew ye. But you know, one supervillain we know pretty well is Rick. Because it turns out, Rick in all of his upsetness got seriously drunk that night. And in the middle of the night, in like his drunken rage, he killed the big baddie and set up this elaborate Saw game just to prove to the Vindicators that they're not actually completely good guys, and they're not just doing this to save the universe. They're also in it for themselves. And yes, they do call it a Saw game. Morty calls him out. He's like, this is like Saw, isn't it? And the sober Rick goes, no, 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 this is not like Saw. And then the film drunk Rick's like, this is totally like Saw. There's just a great dynamic here. The minute we got drunk Rick behind everything that was happening, it just got 100 times better. 100 times better. So there's a lot of crazy shenanigans, a lot of traps with that, that he's trying to prove to the Vindicators that, you know, you guys aren't so great. And of course, Morty solves all of them because he loves the Vindicators. He knows everything about the Vindicators. But at the same time, he knows that Rick hates them. So he solves everyone. And when the Vindicators are like, whoa, how did you do that? Morty's like, Rick's trying to prove this point, and this is the specific point he's trying to prove of how terrible you guys are. And pretty much they go through the whole death trap system like that. And at least one of the Vindicators always falls for it. Then there's a couple of the Vindicators. There's like a love triangle going on between this guy that's made up of a million or a thousand ants, and this Nova space lady, and then this guy that can summon ghost trains. They have like a huge lover spat. And the ant guy kills the ghost train guy. I'm still not quite sure what to make of that. That was interesting. I couldn't follow up on that because I was too absorbed in finding out what drunk Rick was going to say next. And then the end where he completely loses it. He just starts rambling on about Hawaii and things, and then he passes out, and that's kind of the end of the game. So at the end of all of it, there is one final challenge, and that final challenge, Drunk Rick says, is put the one thing that I care about in the center, and I'll spare him, and then the rest of you are out, or, you know, if you choose right, then you all supposedly survive. So Morty just steps up, because he's so sure. He's like, it's gonna be me. I know it's gonna be me, because deep down, Rick actually cares about me. So it dings. It says that he's correct. He, like, goes through this really bootleg It's a Small World ride that somehow Drunk Rick put together. That's kind of the impressive thing. The fact that Rick, when he was drunk, did like this huge, crazy, elaborate scheme and took out supposedly the biggest, baddest world destroyer. World Ender! That was his name! World Ender! I just remembered it. So sorry about that. It completely slipped my mind because I was just too excited to talk about the fact that he's dead the moment we see him. I'm sorry. I really enjoyed the promo leading up to the anticlimactic moment. It was beautiful. You tried fooling us, but Justin Roiland, you couldn't fool us with your sarcasm. Nope, could see right through it. You're like the Alex Hirsch of adult cartoons, and I love it. You two guys are awesome. I love it when you get together and just talk smack about each other. It's beautiful. Anyway, I'm getting off topic. Where was I? Oh, right. So, at the end, Morty goes through, like, this tunnel, and Rick's saying all these nice things, and then it turns out he's not even talking about Morty. He's talking about kind of some humdrum sidekick character who's been assigned to janitorial duty for the Vindicators. He's talking about that guy the whole time, so of course Morty's super irritated at that. He's not happy with Rick at all. And at the end, there's only two Vindicators left. There's the Nova space girl, and then there's the 1000 ants guy, and the Nova space girl is not happy. She's like, Rick, this is all your fault. I'm gonna exact revenge on you for everything that you've done. So in a way, she almost becomes the bad guy because she kills the 1000 ants dude. She like kills the queen that's inside him, and supposedly that means all the ants can't be conscious or sentient or anymore, however that works. The whole concept of that, well, the concept of most of the Vindicators was kind of out there to begin with, which was kind of the point, again, mocking superhero comics and how out there they can be. But the Nova Space Woman's the only Vindicator left. She's ready to, like, exact her revenge on that moment, and then they lift up, and it's a giant party. a giant party. So apparently Drunk Rick set up a party, set up a saw trap, killed World Ender, did all of that before he managed to pass out in a horribly embarrassing way. Like, man, how smart have you gotta be to have all that happen to you and then not remember any of it? Like, how often does that happen to Rick? But we know that Drunk Rick happens more than we see on screen, because the way Morty answers all the questions, and it the sort of the dull response Morty gets to the reaction of seeing how terribly drunk Rick got. We can see this is not Morty's first time going through this. And we have seen Morty deal with drunk Rick before, but that's when Morty really didn't know how to handle it and he was like really freaking out. So now we're actually seeing a Morty that knows what to expect from certain personalities of Rick, at least with drunk Rick, which was very interesting because we see like the development of Morty and how he's going from being this guy that used to be super panicky all the time, and now he's just kind of getting tired of Rick's antics. I mean, he still goes along, but he speaks out a lot more, and he's a lot more firm than he was in the past couple of seasons. Which, I don't know, that might lead up to something, or it may not, but just seeing the fact that Morty's a little bit more strict and a little bit more not dealing with Rick's junk as well as he usually does, at least not in the panicked frenzy that he used to get, and that's interesting. Maybe we'll see Morty like rebel or something in the future. I have no clue. But this was a great episode. I loved it. This was hilarious, especially with the promo buildup. Once again, that was like the buildup to that world ender joke. Because if you just watch the episode, you go, oh, okay, yeah, that kind of makes sense. But honestly, hearing the creators and the animators on the show try and build up this character that just gets killed by Rick when he's drunk is the best thing ever. So I don't know if they'll have stuff like that in the future. I'm expecting that they will. So just note to all of us in the future, make sure to watch the promos. Not the Adult Swim ones where they just have like the little snippets of the next episode, but like the ones where they're quote-unquote interviewing the animators and interviewing Dan Harmon and interviewing Justin Roiland about the next episode. Because there you kind of get subtle little clues on exactly what might be going on in the episode. And I certainly got a big clue that World Ender was not all that they were building him up to be. And that did not disappoint. So I got a big kick out of that. And I'm rambling, so I'm going to end it here because I am tired. And I'm sure lots of people are tired as well, enjoying this Rick and Morty episode. So, if you liked this, go ahead and put a thumbs up and press that like button. And don't forget to comment and subscribe as well. And I will see you next week for the next Rick and Morty!